Hello friends, you are more than welcome to your own channel TNPSC Master. And this video is all about the current affairs notes for the month of January 2020. Please do check the description box for this video's PDF, and for more study materials you may visit our website tnpscmaster.com. If you are preparing for any other type of the competitive exam, definitely these videos and the PDF and the study materials what you can see the TNPSC Master will be helpful for you. Well, all the best, do well in your examination. With this we will start our video. Lieutenant General S.K. Saini appointed as India's Vice Chief of Army Staff. Southern Army Commander Lieutenant General S.K. Saini will take charge as the new Vice Chief of Army Staff on January 25, 2020. Manoj Shashidhar appointed as CBI Joint Director. Senior IPS Officer of Gujarat Grade, Manoj Shashidhar was appointed as Joint Director in the country's premier investigating agency CBI. World's shortest man Khajendra Timagar passed away. Khajendra Timagar was 27 years old and he passed away in the hospital in Nepal. He stood at just 67.08 centimeter tall and was declared as the shortest man alive by Guinness World Record in the year of 2010 after turning 18. Hipendra Mishra appointed as chairman of Nehru Memorial. Hipendra Mishra, former principal secretary to Prime Minister Narendra Modi, has been appointed as chairman of the executive council of the Nehru Memorial Museum and Library, the highest decision making body of the institution. Next point is, Tamil Nadu tops in fake rupees 2000 notes seized in 2018. Tamil Nadu topped the country in the number of fake rupees 2000 notes seized as well as in their face value in 2018. National Crime Records Bureau data showed of the figure 54,776 notes of rupees 2000 seized across the country in 2018. Tamil Nadu accounted for 23%, that is 12,560, followed by West Bengal with 18%, that is 9,615, and Karnataka with 12.3%, that is 6,750. Google topped app download in Q4 2019. For the first time in 5 years, Google has snatched the reins from Facebook to become the world's top publisher of mobile apps short of. In the last quarter of 2019, Google amassed close to 850 million downloads compared to Facebook's nearly 800 million, according to data from App Intelligence Monitor Sensor TAR. Ashley Conti won women's singles title at Adelaide International. She won her first career title at home on 18 January 2020 with a 6-2, 7-5 defeat of Kirin Dayana at the ATP WTA Adelaide International. The world number one is assured of holding the top ranking as the Australian Open begins in Melbourne. IIM Kozhikode to host international conclave on globalizing Indian thoughts. The Indian Institute of Management Kozhikode is hosting an international conclave on globalizing Indian thoughts from January 16 to 18, 2020. The 3-day academic conclave to be inaugurated by the Honorable Prime Minister through video conferencing will witness representations from renowned academicians, public figures, and the presentations of more than 100 world-class research papers. First session of India-Norway Dialogue on Trade and Investment held in New Delhi. The first session of India-Norway Dialogue on Trade and Investment was convened in New Delhi on 15-16 January 2020. The session was based on the terms of reference signed between India and Norway on 8 January 2019 in New Delhi during the visit of the Prime Minister of Norway. This was the first meeting after the signing of DTI. Next point is, Assam and World Bank signed dollar 88 million loan agreement to implement inland water transport project. The Government of India, the Government of Assam and the World Bank signed a loan agreement of $88 million to help modernize Assam's passenger ferry sector that runs on the river including mighty Brahmaputra. Please note this type of points because these may be very important for your examination. Next point is IIT Madras researchers developed device to generate hydrogen fuel from seawater. IIT Madras developed device to produce clean hydrogen fuel from seawater. Researchers from the Indian Institute of Technology Madras have developed a novel device that can be used to generate hydrogen fuel from seawater. An advance that may contribute to a cleaner energy future. Hallmarking of gold jewelry compulsory from January 15, 2021. The government has made the process of hallmarking of gold jewelry mandatory, but it will take 1 year time to the jewelers to register themselves with BIS, that is Bureau of Indian Standards, to and clear their old stock. So from 15 January 2021, no jewelers will be allowed to sell any ornaments without hallmarking. Next point is Sikhs included as a separate ethnic group for the first time in US census. For the first time, Sikhs in the US will be counted as a separate ethnic group for in the year of 2020 census. An organization of the minority community said on Tuesday, describing it as a milestone moment. President of Sikh Society of San Diego, Baljit Singh, said that Sikh community's efforts have come to fruition. Coast Guards of India and Japan conduct Sahyog Kenjing exercise. Indian and Japanese Coast Guard participate in a joint exercise, Sahyog Kenjing, on January 16. The aim behind this exercise is to strengthen the bond between the two countries. One ship of the Japanese Coast Guard and four ships and an aircraft of the Indian Coast Guard participated in the joint exercise. The drill is a five-day event. India's first Su-30 fighter squadron to be stationed in Tanjore, Tamil Nadu. Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh would inaugurate the induction ceremony of Su-30 fighter squadron at the Air Force Station in Tanjore in Tamil Nadu. Now let's have a look upon the single line current affairs. Vigyan Samagam to be held from 21st January in New Delhi. Indian Army conduct airborne in exercise being radar. CSIR partner with the DRDO to produce the Saras engine. People Bihari Shah elected as a bureau member of IUPSC. Indian heritage in digital space being organized in New Delhi. International Heritage Symposium organized in New Delhi. Global economy grew 2.3% in 2019. Home Minister Amit Shah signs Bruin refugee agreement in New Delhi. Fifth edition of Raisiana Dialogue 2020 held in New Delhi. World Economic Forum released 15th Global Risk Report in 2020. Three new species, frog species discovered in Arunachal Pradesh. ICICI Bank unveils ICICI Bank API banking portal. Mikhail becomes the new Prime Minister of Russia. Anshu Malik won silver in 2020 home ranking series. Sania and Nadia won women's double title at Hobart International. Jess Kopman appointed as analytical coach of the women's hockey team. If you like this video, please do like it, share it and subscribe my channel for more videos and let us know what exactly you are looking for from our channel through the comment. Thank you for watching my videos.